10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Witch Doctor!
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Enchantress!
Seconds remaining. Prepare for battle.
That's right, this could be the last game of this whole entire tournament. Team Secret, everything on the line here, but it may be a little bit of an awkward draft, but at the very least, they are going out on signature heroes. Blitz, we've got a Enchantress Puppy as well as a Weeha Meepo.
Yeah, that's actually what I was going to point out, is that everybody just kind of has their comfort heroes. You've got Weeha playing the Meepo, Puppy playing the Enchantress, the Pileidai Bounty Hunter, that's yeah. super well known. That's mm-hmm. like the perfect hero for him, because it doesn't matter if it dies,
yeah.
and it can scout for free. It's so hard to kill.
Who knows, he may even run into that five-man smoke gank and not even die. We'll have to see. Vega Squadron, he's already doing some scouting. Vega are actually running the three-man aggression into the enemy jungle. And does this mean they're actually swapping things out? Mag is heading up to the top lane right now.
I actually think they want to try to get aggressive here because they understand that the Witch Doctor is quite good against the Enchantress, so even going for the aggressive tri-lane, it's going to be really hard for Puppy to actually get the stun off, and this would actually be so huge because then it's a misery 1v1 against a Broodmother. That's not a great matchup. And
no.
But for me, it's like the Meepo is going to be the X factor in this game. Whether or not Weeha can just go ham. He actually does really well against the Queen of Pain, obviously, because you can net control him. Same with the Broodmother. You can just kind of poof on top of all of her broodlings. And that actually ends your split push, because if you think about it, you send one Meepo with the rest of your team, and then you just split up, poof a bunch on top, push out the lane, and then you can still meet your team in time.
Yeah, I like the way that I think if anyone's really thinking that this is going to be the game for Secret, they're putting a lot of faith in the Weeha Meepo, just like Marlini did. So the aggro tri-lane comes out from Vega Squadron. They will be left in that 1v1 matchup, Mag versus Misery, who doesn't have any sort of counter vision. Puppy's early rotations are obviously going to be critical. We'll see what he can find. Pileidai has already managed to take away one counter ward.
By going for this aggressive tri-lane too, you actually force the Meepo to be in a straight 1v1 against no one, because the Bounty Hunter isn't going to want to move off of this lane, right? Because you're already losing top lane. By going top, you're not really doing anything. Maybe by going mid, you'd be okay, but at the same time, you're going to lose the safe lane. And so they kind of have to salvage at least one of these lanes, and it's probably going to be most likely the safe lane. But still, the laning phase is going to be so rough for Secret, like they talked about in the pregame.
Hi. Takes a bit of damage. They do have a lot of aggression coming out in this middle lane as no one putting pressure on the Meepo, but can't quite get the kill. Now the Enchantress. This is the big advantage, of course, of the Enchantress over, say, the Chen. Being able to have two different big creeps at the same time. And I really like the fact that he was able to pick up the Satyr Tormentor. That is such a big pickup. They needed some sort of spamming here, creep. And not just like something like a Hellbearer Smasher. No. The problem is still going to be that the cast causes a lot of issues. Take some time to work through these creeps, but they will get the kill on at least one of them. Even if they are being zoned out.
Yeah, and you want Vega to force abilities onto that just because you can't really gank with those two creeps. Like if Vega feels any sort of threat, they're just actually just gonna run away, and he actually grabs the rune and no one's just gonna blink away, but he's further away from his bottle than he wants to be. This
Pi, he's got a haste rune. He's committing for the kill onto Sam of the Slayer. They actually pop the dust, but it's not enough to get the kill on Witch Doctor first. Pi will die in return, but they get first blood.
That was so huge for them right now, because this tri-lane, we talked about it, I thought it was gonna be pretty rough for them, but even getting the first blood for a psychological lead is pretty good. And this is gonna kinda tell Vega, like, we have to play at least a little bit more scared than we have been so far.
Do you think that there needs to be more pressure on Weeha's Meepo? Do they rotate the Witch Doctor middle at all? Is no one is obviously having some issues with that. Gets caught by the first net, follow up second net, double poof, and no one's down to 100 HP.
That Meepo is actually really good against the power of the Queen of Pain, just mm-hmm. because you can rotate throughout them. It doesn't really matter if you harass one because he's got the second one as a backup. If you get caught by the net at this phase, it's almost a kill.
Yeah, no one's having to play pretty far back. Once you start getting the level 2 Earthbind, I'm presuming you're not going to go any levels of Geostrike and just commit more for the range of Earthbind at this point.
Getting one level I think is okay, but I'm not really a Meepo player.
Yeah. It just feels like the difference between the 500 and 750 range, like no one could sit all the way back but still be caught by a potential net, which, you know, who knows if the Meepo is able to pick up an actual kill from there.
Yeah, but Weeha's still doing a really good job of just farming out right now. the pace of the game is actually really going in Secret's favor. They're actually
they're
even
gonna
going to
run down Pasha. Yeah, they
there's
should
no
be
Witch Doctor.
Kill. Easy pick off. And that's the downside. If you rotate the Witch Doctor into that middle lane, immediately the bottom lane's going to get aggressive and shut down that gyrocopter. Still, though, they do have Mag free farming away against Misery. Misery's not doing too bad, though. 17 and 2 compared to the 28 on Mag. And his Ice Shard spam will be able to pick up a little bit of extra kills on the Spiderlings.
With this bottle, he should be okay, but the issue is that eventually he'll run out of steam and mana, and then the Brood kind of just strikes when Misery decides to leave the lane. At the same time, though, this aggressive tri-lane has just completely failed for Vegas Squadron. The good news is they were able to keep the Bounty Hunter down here, but if they're getting kills, then it's not that big of a deal for Secret.
Yeah.
And that was just such an intelligent rotation by Puppy, recognizing, okay, Seema the Slayer has shown himself mid. That means that I can just go for this gank, and there's actually nothing they can do about it.
No one comes back to the middle lane. He's level 5. Weeha is already level 6. Does go for that one level Geo Strike, forcing out the blink just by running at no one. That's all he has to do. Ember Spirit is going to be caught as the glimpse comes back. They have the cast. It bounces back to Eternal Envy. They may get the kill, but no such luck. EE slips away. Middle lane, they're going to catch no one here. They manage to get the poof, poof, poof. And Weeha picks up a kill.
He had already used his blink because he's so afraid of this lane right now.
Yeah.
It's actually absurd how scared no one is of just getting netted once and instantly killed. And that's a real possibility with two levels of the poof, or four levels of the poof and two meepos alive. And he has to be so careful now. And the laning phase has become really, really, really strong for Secret.
Yeah, I almost feel like that Vega Squadron might have been better off if they just ran a defensive tri-lane and rotated the supports into middle lane as ganking heroes and just left Mag at the bottom lane, because right now they can't really rotate into the middle lane to shut down the Meepo, because that just leaves the gyrocopter open to aggression.
Their strategies of this entire tournament has just been trying to win at least two out of the three lanes, mm-hmm. but I almost feel like they kind of pressed their luck a little bit too much by trying to go for three here. And Secret just kind of outplayed them. Like, the mid rotation where the Witch Doctor...
Oh, do they actually get the kill on Mag? Yes, they do! Snowball in, finish him off with a Walrus Punch.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, the one here that was actually doing well. Maybe they can catch out Weeha, though. They've thrown him down with a Shatter Strike, but he actually gets a Haste Rune, so he can even turn things around.
This is so bad for Vega now. You've lost all three of the lanes, even the lane that you were supposed to win, The Tusk isn't even far behind. Like, before that gank, he was doing just fine. And now that he's got the Arcane Boots, he's not going to run out of steam anymore. He can pretty much just spam these Ice Shards. And with the Bounty Hunter up here, there's a lot of kill potential now in this lane.
Things looking very good for Team Secret. The first 6 minutes of this game, 4-1 to their favor. Pylite Die setting up for yet another gank on Mag. They know the other lanes are going to be fine, especially with Eternal Envy at level 5 has that level 3 Flame Guard that's able to soak up so much damage. Pilot Eye is no longer needed in that situation, so if they can continue to shut down Mag, as you said, they've won every single lane.
And they're just going to stick Pilot Eye up here so he can get his level 6, and then he's even more of a threat to Mag. And on top of that, he can scout ahead for his Meepo, and it doesn't really matter if the Bounty Hunter dies at this phase of the game anymore. As long as Weeha's doing good, he can pretty much burst down everybody on Vega by himself. So all you have to really do here is get Pilot Die level 6 at a reasonable time, which he is right now. He's almost level 5 right now. And then you can just rotate around the lanes, and it doesn't really matter if you go for one-for-one trades.
Mag still getting a decent amount of farm despite not even leaving his tier 1 tower area. They're gonna go for Weeha here in the middle lane. The poof out. Is he safe? He gets away. The Shadow Strike doesn't look like the damage is gonna be enough. He even has a bottle charge still left, so a heavy amount of committal there for Vega Squadron doesn't get it. Misery's gonna be run down in the top lane. Mag, I don't think he has the damage. One more nuke isn't going to be nearly enough. And there's still another bottle charge. Pasha's going to be in some trouble, I think, at this bottom lane with the rotation coming out from Puppy. He leads with the troll and does have the centaur. Unfortunately, took kind of the wrong path, and Eternal Envy wasn't there to be able to get the chains as a follow-up either. So, unfortunate gank does fail, but Team Secret still controlling this game.
At the same time, that's perfectly fine. Forcing a level 5 gyro out of the lane, it's not like it's really easy for him to go to that top lane now either, because the Tusk has so much farm that he can just spam out once or twice with the Ice Shards, and then all of a sudden Pasha has to be careful of the solo kill. And that Broodmother has that the network of webs set up at top, and you don't want to just give that up. So he is eventually going to leave, but this isn't even an ideal swap for them.
Misery
It's a little hard sometimes to secure those catapult kills against the tower, so he just simply walrus punches it and utilizes the regen. They'll go right back up to full. Is this going to be an early medallion into the Solar Crest build for the Tusk, or do you see better utility out of like a mech build for this game, since he did go for the Arcane Boots?
Going for a mech isn't bad, even a Blink Dagger, just to lead with. When you have heroes like the Ember Spirit, you don't want him to have to commit so hard with his Fire Remnants early on in the game, and he doesn't have enough levels of the Sleight of Fist to really initiate for you. So it's pretty decent for him to get a Blink Dagger, I think, this game. And it's really difficult for Weehaw to get the nets off if everyone's playing ideal.
Yeah. So maybe having that early initiator from the Tusk would be a better idea, but he's gonna go for the mech. I mean, he's far enough ahead that you can see mech and then a Blink Dagger before, I mean, potentially 20 minutes, considering it's only 9 minutes in right now. Pylite die. He almost gets kind of caught, but Mag isn't there in time for the extra nuke, and no one doesn't have a Sonic Wave. For a little while, he tried to actually throw out a Blind Scream and doesn't actually find the Bounty Hunter.
He was actually just outside of range for that, but this is what Pylite die does. He just pokes and prods you and annoys you more than anything. And he's about to hit level 6, and this has been pretty successful for him. He was able to get the kill off on bottom lane. He rotates top with the dust, picks off the Broodmother at the same time. And this has been an incredibly successful Bounty Hunter. And if they could get this top kill too.
Yep, Gyrocopter does go down. Witch Doctor, he's probably going to go down as well. No one comes in with the ultimate Sonic Wave, but it's still not enough to really threaten these heroes. Puppy even turns around for a couple of pod shots there, as he knows no one's completely out of mana. No blink, no screen. Mag's going to come in from the side here and try and go for the kill on a Puppy. Does manage to get it real quick. He will be tracked up. Snowball follows him down. This is a bit dangerous, but Misery will be able to get the Walrus Punch. Misery's heavily committed here, but there's no response because Meepo's pushing back the Witch Doctor. And Mag, he's
going to
be hit by the Ice Shards. Locked in. Weehaw gets him with the net, and that's a Spider Trap. Double kill for Weehaw.
What a rotation by him. It took me for the last second to see, okay, he's actually got some backup, and Misery, it looked like an over-aggressive play, but Weehaw just kind of flanks from the side, and that's so huge. And at bottom, Eternal Envy wants more.
Solo, he's kind of looking for the glimpse, but it looks like he's going to be just fine juking his way through the trees. I think Eternal Envy knew that even if he did catch the Disruptor somehow, he was just going to be sent back, and Disruptor would probably TP immediately afterwards, but...
And this is the strength right now of Weehaw. He can just send one of the Meepos up at top, pressure the Gyrocopter, and at the same time, farm out mid and all of the jungle. And he's almost got his Aghanim Scepter ready. And I think off of Meepo timings, from what I've seen in pubs at least, about 12, 13 minutes is standard for your Ags if you're farming stacks. But because of the amount of kills that he has, he's pretty accelerated right now.
Yeah, Treads Bottle, and another 600 gold for that Aghanim Scepter solo. Not quite caught, does get a good kinetic field, and if anything, if there was TPs and maybe Disruptor was level 6, you could see him trying to go for the kill in the Ember Spirit, but he gets it now, and this was the big turnaround for Vega Squadron, or at least not turnaround, they were really able to capitalize on the level 6 of the Disruptor last time. We'll see if they can do it again here.
Oh, Pylite Die has a dust as well.
Yeah, Mag is going to be caught, that's going to be a track kill too. Team Secret really showing how to deal with the Mag Broodmother in this game. The ultimate goes out in the middle lane. They will catch Weehaw, so it's a trade-off. Yes, the free farming Broodmother has been shut down by Team Secret, but at least Weehaw has been picked off a couple times as well.
You absolutely needed to do that, and Vega had to rotate the Gyrocopter in. It almost feels like overkill, but you can't afford to lose out on that kill at that phase of the game. Going for the smoke gank and having to bring your carry in, you might as well just drop everything. So right now, Pylite Die is just creating a little bit of space. You've got the mech up on Misery now. So the burst damage that the Brood had...
Oh, the silence! They caught Eternal Envy, but can they actually burst him down in time? The Sonic Wave, the extra bit of nuke damage, close back after he jumps over! He's still trying to get out, but they provide some extra heroes. The Broodmother and Pasha Bishu come in order to make sure that Eternal Envy does die. Great catch there from Solo, leading with that Static Storm kinetic field.
Now the tides are starting to churn, and this is so huge for Vega. Like, they're rotating all their cores, but they've done this before, and usually they have a lead at this phase of the game as a result of the laning phase, but they're so good at doing this mid-game timing with all their cores.
Misery will be able to make a snowball play here, potentially. Well, never mind, it's Puppy.
I doubt he wants to be close range with the hero, so he's just going to do a solo snowball here. Kinetic Field still kind of trapped Misery in. He gets on the other side of it. He's going to fight Pasha with Urn. They will be able to get the kill. Misery's being run down, but he's so damn tanky. He's still got a mech as well. Solo is being right-clicked to death by this Enchantress with all those embedded shots. Mag, he's actually down to half HP with a track on top of him. He's going to go down as well as the Witch Doctor. No one. He comes in, but there's not much he can really provide. No potential turnaround.
Oh, no. Solo.
Solo, he's been found by Weeha as well. And that'll be a fourth kill. Going to Team Secret, 12-5 now.
You know what the funniest thing that was? Is that Solo, they forgot about him completely. They had no idea he was down there. He hid himself so far away, but he used the glimpse to send Eternal Envy back to base. So it's almost like the screw you play, but
yeah,
he ends up paying for it. Like, there's a reasonable chance he might have been able to live there. He had mana for the TP. It was one or the other. It's like, okay, do I glimpse here or TP out? Mm-hmm. And he decided at the last second to go for the glimpse.
Speaking of Eternal Envy, it looks like he's going for the Buta travel build, not committing for the Urn, has Ring of Akilla, and then just regular Brown Boots. You've seen the Ember Spirit from before, like Ferrari committing with the treads and just, you know, trying to stat up as much as possible for these early fights. Do you feel like Eternal Envy should have gone for that route, or do you think that Secret are winning good enough that the much more efficient Boots of Travel is more valuable?
I think it's fine to go for the travels. In the Ferrari game, he plays the mid-roll, so it's a little bit different.
Sure.
Where being able to tread swap and stuff like that is pretty huge for that hero. Yes, he has a bottle this game around, but his team's created enough space. He doesn't have to be that position one player like that, but yeah. Up at top.
Yeah, they're going to jump in. Looks like a pickoff there on the Ember Spirit. And they're going to throw out the Sonic Wave and try and chase down Puppy at the bottom lane. Mag's going to be caught by the track. Looks like Misery will be able to run him down with a Walrus Punch. Back up to top lane. Puppy, he's gotten himself some serious distance. And there's going to be a TP in now from Weeha onto this tier 1 tower.
Oh,
that nets Pasha Bishu, but the cast is actually bouncing around. They're turning things around on the Meepo. If he goes down here, all those Meepos will die. And yes, it finally dies. Pylite Die going to be chased down. The dust isn't quite there to catch him. And Vega Squadron, this time around, are the ones to walk away big. Yes, they lost Mag at the bottom lane, and that was a track kill as well, but they get Eternal Envy to start with, still clean up Puppy, and Weeha coming in, thinking he could turn things around, but that great cask from the Witch Doctor is what set everything up.
That cask was so fortuitous, Cap, and they were actually so close to killing everybody from Vega at top. Everybody just walks away with 200 HP, but Vega's playing the min-max game beautifully. They understand when they're playing against the Bounty Hunter, and the fact that they lost the laning phase as hard as they did, they have to play a little bit risky. And that just means bring your cores in early, get ready to go for these five-man fights early, and just kind of draw the line in the sand.
Yeah, that fight would have been so different if that one Meepo actually managed to survive, and the other three that were quite healthy were able to push forward and would have just caught Vega Squadron their pants down. But we see now a Blink Dagger on Pylite Dai's Bounty Hunter. This is solely because of the fact that we do have the mech on the Tusk. Why would you say Blink Dagger is better than, say, the Medallion?
I think you're just playing the positional game if you're Pylite Dai, yeah. And making sure that you can kind of play that. You hop in, go for a track, hop out, make sure you don't die. We've often seen bounties in this tournament just get picked off as a result of not having any sort of mobility items.
Oh, that's a nice little chunk of change. I'm not sure Weeha expected that. Farms up an easy camp with Poof and actually gets all the spiderlings there.
That's like the weirdest feeling. It's like, wait, why do I have like 300 gold? Alright, Mag has a lot of farm though. He's got 2600 gold. Obviously doesn't have boots yet, but might go for that Misery build where he goes for that straight Radiance. And it would work pretty well against the Meepo, for example, because the Meepo can't go for the BKB.
It's a little weird. I mean, I guess he's been picked off so many times in a row that he has fallen behind both the Queen of Pain and the Gyrocopter.
This is the huge fight coming up. Vega committing everybody once again.
Yeah, they have to win this one. They do actually see the Bounty Hunter coming in from the side, but I think they just kind of want to bait it for a little bit more.
They want to open up on E if they can.
Yeah. And that would be big. They have the track. They're going to catch Eternal Envy here, but he's already jumped himself some distance. Glimpse back, catch him with the Static Field. They're going to throw everything they have to make sure the Ember Spirit does die. Solo goes down in the process. The Sonic Wave goes out and actually hits Eternal Envy as well as Misery in the background, so that's their next target. Misery's going to go down. Mag is actually staying alive until the last impetus shot from Puppy catches him. Puppy is dealing out so much damage in these fights. The Shuriken bounces around, but it's not enough to get the kill on Pasha. So a couple of track kills go the way of Team Secret, plus the number advantage to them as well. Despite that was a smoke setup and everything, and Vega Squadron still walk away the worse for wear.
The problem was that Secret completely sniffed out what was going on. They understood, okay, there's most likely going to be five heroes down there. Vega got behind in the early laning phase. They're just rotating their cores over and over again. Nobody was farming at that top lane, and there's still a tier 1 tower up there. So just good process of elimination. And at the same time, if you hard commit for Envy like that, it's just going to be the Meepo that goes to town.
Oh, no one. He's going to be caught here. A couple of boots come out, but he actually managed to get the blink away. Not the chain stun that Weeha intended. And now one of these Meepos is going to die. Jump in. Oh, Ember Spirit. He's actually still going to fight this one. Jumps right back out. Hello. Oh, goodbye. Glimpse and jumps out once again.
They've got to be so careful right now because Secret, you know, they got out like bandits at that bottom lane, but by feeding away the Meepo, I mean, Vega's gonna feel perfectly fine with what just happened at bottom.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely
a 1,000 gold swing.
Yeah, I mean, he's easily the highest net worth in this game, so his death is worth a lot to Vega Squadron. In fact, the Queen of Pain as well as the Gyrocopter have finally overtaken Misery's Tusk, who's been, you know, staying so far ahead of everybody. Sure enough, he does have that 20 minutes blink dagger and mech with arcane boots. Insane amount of farm on Misery as this offlaner.
They focus so much on slowing down the Ember Spear too, and this is a hero when pressured, doesn't have the best time, especially since he's decided to go for this Treads build, opting to instead kind of fight with his team a little bit more, but he just hasn't really found openings, and it's really difficult for him too. When he's playing against a hero like Disruptor that can just instantly kill him once he gets hit by the Glimpse Static Storm combo, he has to be so careful.
Puppy is actually a little bit surprised he's not going maybe for like the Ags just because he's, or not the Ags, sorry, the minus into the Ags just because he has been giving so much space in many ways. Mags is going to be caught. Pylite dies running around with a gem right now, and that makes easy pickoffs for the Broodmother. And really, these pickoffs pay for themselves when you get track kills on top of it.
Yeah, and this is the strength of the Blink Dagger on the Bounty Hunter. When he grabs the gem, Brood just isn't safe anywhere, and they're gonna go for this 5-man push. They kind of understand that they've been letting Vega set the tempo a little bit too much, Cap. So they're saying to themselves, okay, we're finally gonna go for the 5-man ourselves. When we have both our Meepo and our Ember Spirit, how do you actually kill both of them?
Tier 2 tower gonna be threatened as a result. Pasha does take the Tier 1 at top lane as a result. Looks like he'll complete his SNY soon. Roshan is up, and they do have the Enchantress to tank it with Untouchable and a double damage.
Meepos are just gonna poof on in.
Yeah, and then he picks up the double damage, and all of a sudden, makes things a whole lot easier for them.
This is such a huge Aegis too.
Yeah, Weeha will be able to jump in just with impunity.
It's like 8 lives. It's pretty much worth it, just because there's no transformation effect or anything like that for the Meepo.
Yeah.
So this is a really hard reset for him. And this is just gonna mean that Secret's just gonna continue to 5-man probably, and go for the tier 1 at top. And then from there, just kind of establish some tempo, clear out the jungles, finally give Envy some space to farm.
He's probably going to be building into that Battle Fury soon. He's got 2,400 gold. I'm a little bit surprised he hasn't bought any of the components. Is there anything else he would go for?
I've been thinking about it right now. Probably not.
Yeah, there's like, Manta was sometimes picked up, but that's only in response to the Orchid, and there is no Orchid. Vega Squadron, no one chose to go for the Axe build this game on the Queen of Pain, and obviously the Broodmother. I mean, the Broodmother technically can still go for it. Maybe that's what he's banking on. He knows Broodmother has a lot of gold. He's only operated on this Midas for so long, but it turns out that's actually going to be a relic. We're going to be seeing a Radiance Broodmother right away from Ag.
Yeah, and that's what I thought that he would go for when he has 2,800 gold and he's saving up like that.
Yeah.
And we talked about it before, when you're playing against the Meepo, he's never going to go for a BKB, so going for the Radiance is perfectly fine. Like, that actually works so well against the Meepo. What is he going to get? MKB, BKB? Neither of those items are really options for him.
Yeah. So he's actually not very far away, just another 1,100 gold. Vega Squadron will get a big upgrade to the team fights that Broodmother is actually a part of. That's probably the harder part. Weeha, it looks like he's going to be going for the Scythe of Ice up next. The blink in, Scythe, and poof, poof, poof.
That's an instant kill. And when you're this far ahead of Meepo, and you've got an Aegis, like, that's the best commitment you can get. Because no matter what, you'll trade one for Aegis, and they're probably going to get a free kill right now.
Yeah, Pasha is just going to get blown up. He gets off the call down, but there's just no one around from Vega Squadron to take advantage of that one. They also take away the ward. They've caught a Turtle Envy, but the rest of the Team Secret is going to be coming in through the side. Envy, can he live through this one? The extra heal! Oh, he dies to the Shadow Strike. Solo, he's going to be caught, blocked out by the Ice Shards, and will be fed away. But still, they caught a Turtle Envy. That's something, especially since he was holding on to, I think, a decent amount of unreliable gold at the time. He has bought some of the items building into his Battle Fury, though.
That's huge for Vega. The fact that they lost their gyrocopter, but you return get their carry only for a disruptor, that was one of the better scenarios that you could have asked for. If no one dies there, which is what Secret was hoping for, then yeah, that's an excellent trade for Secret, but Eternal Envy's already far behind.
Oh, he thought he could get out in time, but Uiha sniffed it out. Blink and throws the long range net. Now Mag, you may be caught as well. You have Puppy making his way over.
Oh, run, Mag.
Yeah, mass TPs are coming out. And Mag, he's a hungry little spider. He wants to be able to just eat Puppy, but he can't actually get close enough. Now Pasha's going to go for Puppy next, but he's already got the heal going. Then my brain is here now. Going to be enough. Now Weeha's going to be able to jump right onto Pasha. Eats him alive. And the rest of Vega Squadron on full retreat now. Solo is the only one who may be going down as well. Yeah, no one. He can't do anything to stop this. Solo dies. And whoa, the net actually caught no one. Don't tell
me.
He's
going
to go down as well. Chain that snowball through. That's a team wipe. Team Secret hitting back big in game number two now, 24-12, 24 minutes in. Once again, a game where we're seeing a kill a minute from one of these teams.
You just can't run away from that Meepo at that phase of the game. Once he's got his Blink Dagger, you've got a Blink Dagger on both Misery and the Bounty Hunter too. And all of these track kills add up so quickly. And look at that net range.
Yep, and that catches the Witch Doctor. He's dead. He tries to show himself, but Vega Squadron, they're just falling apart. They do have the buyback on the Witch Doctor if they want to try and contest this with the Gyro coming back. But the melee Rax is already gone before the Gyro is even revived.
Honestly, this just feels like Vega isn't really familiar with playing against the Meepo, like the power of the net and the distance of it. They're standing so far back and they're probably thinking to themselves, that actually reaches that far? Because how often do you play against Meepo competitively?
Oh, big static storm potentially. Weeha gets both his Meepos out. And there is one Meepo though stuck inside. The Sonic Wave goes out. They get the Guarding Grease, but he does go down. That's just the Aegis though, gents. And Puppy, well, he's got Maledict on him. He's trying to heal through it. Maybe will survive. They have to turn around for the Meepo though, because he's now caught no one. We'll take out the Queen of Pain. Witch Doctor's up next. He's gone. And Vega Squadron, once again, left with this scenario where there's only two heroes to defend. And they know this time around with no buybacks, they can't afford to lose the second lane of Rax, so they just call it.
Yeah, this was just entirely Vega's tactical decision to go for the aggressive tri-lane. If it fails like that, and it did, it was just Secret outmaneuvering them. Puppy with the Enchantress rotation at bottom. Once he sees the Witch Doctor leave, it was great.
Yeah, I feel like Vega Squadron, I think you really hit the nail on the head when you mentioned